Druth was a troubled man. A scholar turned slave. They tortured him. Took him with them on their raids. Drove him to madness. Spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds. To my world. Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. His tales of hell were true. Then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him. Until she too could see what he saw. Have you ever died before? It's a serious question. When the illusion of self is shattered, you simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Senua has died before. And she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
She will die!
Ah!
She's gone!
Yes, Senua!
The gate won't open.
She can't get through.
Why not?
She must go to the gate.
She can't.
Why?
She's only done one test.
Just one.
She's only
passed
one test.
What's the other test? Is there another one?
Said Valravn.
Valravn. Dark magic.
Valravn. Druth said Valravn.
No, he didn't.
She must pass the test. The second test.
She can sense darkness coming.
She has to challenge Valravn.
There must be another test.
Valravn is magic.
If she wants to open the gate,
he can see.
Challenge Valravn. Once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Raven's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look how much it's changed.
Ravens.
I hear something.
If you hear the song of Valravan, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions. You can't always trust your eyes.
Challenge me! Berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. such a person a gelt? Some, like truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like sin, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now. She can get up now. What's happening? She can get up now.
She can get up.
Must be
magic.
Dark
magic.
A trick. Valravan.
Tricking her.
Valravan.
How can she get up?
Wait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not him. He's helping her. It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own.
It's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Don't give up.
The worst kind comes without warning.
She can't go in there.
A deep and primal signal from within.
Valravan,
a reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Go round. Find your own path.
There's a different way.
Finish! Get out!
Behind you!
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars, and to protect them.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
The song. Balravan. Balravan's song. It's over here. It's over here.
Is that? It's over there. No, it's here. There's two.
Listen, focus, listen.
It's magic. It's magic. It's an illusion. She's been in the forest like this before.
This reminds her.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and gathered them in his mind and learned them. Then he fell from the tree.
Ravens.
Where have they gone?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, thought, grow in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.
The gate is open!
Open!
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion? Before her time comes.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keep. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together. Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, They betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
The gate is open!
Wait.
Open!
I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me. Didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in,
it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
Help me. But there,
help,
in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me.
Help,
Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus,
like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there! Beat you in the wilds, did I? It was an illusion. But not this time!
The mark of Valravn. One of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.